Hatred is never appeased by hatred in this world. By non-hatred is hatred appeased. This is an eternal law. What I find very interesting about this verse is that although there are some translations in the internet that say hatred is only appeased by love or loving kindness, that is not the case if you look at the original text, because what the original text is saying is verana, hatred, and then averana, that A in the front meaning non. So why is the Buddha here saying hatred and non-hatred rather than hatred and love? Now, my experience is this. If we receive a hurt, whether justified or not, but something that we hold in ourselves and we hold a grudge and we ruminate about it, it is like if we keep a burning charcoal in our hand, which in the end only burns us and makes us feel very ill. So if we try instead to suppress it, saying, no, I don't have these feelings, you know, I must love, I have to love this person, it's not honest. So sometimes it's just a question of the perception that this grudge is just hurting me, so I want to let it go. I just want to let it go. And what happens when you let it go, then there is a feeling of release, of, you know, and then loving kindness arises, you know, a certain sense of lovingness arises. And when that happens, we can see the situation a lot more clearly, and we also make it easier for reconciliation. So because we will be able to talk to the other person without strong recrimination, aggression, anger, so they will feel less threatened and more at ease to talk to us and sort out the situation. So let us meditate today. Whenever you hold a grudge, see how it's hurting you. And then see, with this new feeling that arises, how easier it can be to resolve the situation. If you cannot resolve it, move on, but don't carry it with you. It has happened, it has gone, life is full of hurt and vicissitudes, but what matters is I'm not burning inside, I am at peace. Now we look at the second part of this verse. There are those who do not realize that one day we all must die, but those who realize this settle their quarrels. I'm not going to say very much on this. You catch it easily, you understand it easily. Yes, life is brief. Let us live as happy as possible and contented, and let go of that which is not necessary, and let us enjoy the present moment. Thanks for listening.